Hey, what's up guys? It's Dr. Sami, and today I want to go over a few tips that help me with crown cementations. So I used to really struggle with my crown cementation appointments, but over the past couple years, I picked up a lot of tricks and tips that have helped me really perfect my protocol. Tip number one, adjust the adjacent teeth. So what a lot of people don't realize after they prepare their crown is that you want to look at the adjacent teeth before taking that impression. Sometimes the adjacent teeth have these old fillings, whether they're white or silver fillings, that are sharp and pointed, and they don't have nice, smooth, rounded, you know, natural contours to them. And what happens is you take that impression, you send it to the laboratory, and they're unable to fabricate a crown that has nice broad contacts because the adjacent teeth doesn't really allow them to do that. So my advice is to take a flame-shaped diamond and round out the interproximal surface of the adjacent teeth so that you have a more natural contour to it. You can do this with the flame diamond, or you can even do this with polishing discs and just brush up on it, and you're just trying to eliminate any sharp corners that will prevent the laboratory from creating a nice broad contact on their crown. Number two, round out your preparation. So it's really important for you guys to look at your preparation before taking that impression, because if you look at your crown prep and you have sharp points in the crown prep, when you take the impression and the laboratory, you know, forms a stone model from that impression, little pieces, those sharp pieces that you forgot to round out at the very end, can break off, and then the lab technician will fabricate a crown that isn't really accurate. And then when the crown comes back, you're gonna seat it on there, it's not gonna seat properly, and it's gonna be really frustrating. So take the extra time to look at your preparation, round out the corners, and make sure any of those sharp points are smoothened out. My advice is to use a white stone or even a fine diamond, or once again, we can go back to those discs to round out some of those corners and make sure everything is smooth and clear. Number three, make an awesome provisional crown with good contact and good margins. Why do we want good contact? Because if your provisional crown has an open contact, then over the course of the next 2 weeks, as your laboratory technician is fabricating that crown, teeth will shift ever so slightly. And if they shift, once you get the crown back and you try to seat it, it's not gonna seat perfectly into place. So that's why we're making provisional crowns with good contacts, because we wanna preserve the space so that when we get the final crown back, we can cement it in and it goes really easily. The other tip is to make sure the provisional has really good margins. If you have an open margin, number one, the patient might experience some sensitivity over the next couple weeks, but also number two, more importantly, the gums might drift into that space. And when you take off the provisional crown, now you're gonna have some of this tissue that's on your margin, and you won't be able to properly seat the final crown completely into place. So it's really important to make sure the provisionals are done right. Train your staff well, or if you see that there's a problem, even consider making the provisional yourself. So make really good provisionals. Number four, clean the tooth. At the crown cementation appointment, when you take off the temporary crown, sometimes you're gonna see a lot of excess cement on your preparation. So it's really important to clean off all that cement as well as you can so that you can have a really nice interaction between the intaglio of the crown and the preparation surface. Now, if the patient is experiencing sensitivity, consider getting them numbed up, taking some pumice and dry polishing it, you know, so that all that cement is off and you can just see a really nice clean crown preparation, and then you can go ahead with the cementation protocol. So take that extra time in cleaning the tooth, and it will go a long way when you try in that crown. Number five, check the interproximal contact. Now this is typically gonna be one of the biggest reasons why our crowns won't seat completely. Even if you have a perfect provisional that maintains the space properly, sometimes you get a crown back from the lab and you put it in and the interproximal contacts are just way off. Now, if it's an open contact, then you're gonna wanna send it back to the lab and the lab will add a little bit of porcelain so that you can achieve that nice contact. That's really important so that you don't have a food trap and that patients are able to floss through properly. Now, if the contact is tight, then you're gonna have to adjust the interproximal surface. So typically what I'll do is I'll take an articulation paper, I'll go right in between the two teeth, I'll put the crown on, and I'll see a mark on the crown, a blue mark, that I will then adjust. Now the trick is, when you're adjusting, you don't want to be aggressive with your adjustment. You wanna lightly skim the crown surface so that you don't take off too much, and you're doing it in a way that doesn't cause a divot in the crown. You wanna do a nice rounded adjustment. And then you try back on, and make sure that the flossing contact is good. Now, the way I check the contact is by having my assistant hold the cotton pliers and then hold the crown down, and then I will take the floss and I'll floss through. I always make sure to ask my assistant if they are in a comfortable position and if they're holding the crown down well, because the last thing you want is to floss up and then the crown flies and then you have lost a crown and you need to take another impression and the patient's not very happy with you. So no matter what, just my protocol is I have the assistant hold down the crown. I ask them, hey, are you in a comfortable position? Do you have a good stable, you know, position that you're holding the crown down in? And then I say, okay, I'm gonna go floss. And then I floss through and I will actually floss back up. Sometimes I'll even hold the crown down while flossing back up. This involves, you know, a little bit of experience and a little bit of technique, but it just allows me to feel a little bit more comfortable as I'm checking the flossing so that we don't lose the crown to the back of the patient's throat or we have to take a new impression and we have an unhappy patient. I should mention one other point, which is when you try on the crown, don't force it on. Sometimes you'll put the crown on and you'll snap it into place, and then it's really hard to get the crown back off. I think for most people, this will happen sometime in your career. You can either use a scaler or some other tools to kind of wiggle it back off, but that's why you don't want to force anything into the mouth. So be careful with that as well. Number six, check their bite lightly. So when you have the crown on and you've checked the interproximal contact and the floss isn't threading and there's no open contact, it's nice and tight, it feels good, then you wanna check their occlusion. But you don't wanna have them slam their teeth together. I always tell them, okay, hey, I want you to lightly bite down until your teeth come into contact with one another. And then I say, okay, lightly go up and down, and then I see where those original marks are, because if the lab fabricates a crown that's a bit too high and you have the patient slam down, guess what? You're going to shatter that beautiful porcelain. So just make sure that they, when they originally bite down, that they're doing so in a light manner. And then look at your marks, adjust, and then you can tell them to get more into it and grind left and right. But you don't want to let them do that at the very beginning. Number seven, move the gums out of the way. So we kind of alluded to this earlier in this lecture, I guess it would be. If you have a provisional that has an open margin, sometimes the gums will encroach on top of that margin. So when you take the provisional off, now you can't fully seat that beautiful porcelain crown onto the tooth. It won't seat all the way because the gums are preventing you from seating it completely. So you have to move the gums out of the way. How do you do this? Well, you can pack a cord around the tooth and that will move the gums out of the way. Or if it's a lot and you really can't get the cord in there, then you might have to consider getting the patient slightly numbed up and just taking a little bit of a blade and cutting it out of the way and then trying to cement it back on, or I should say try the crown back on. But that's another problem that a lot of people don't foresee, or they wonder why their crowns aren't seating all the way, and it's because the gums are preventing you from seating it completely. Number eight, adjust the intaglio of the crown. So this also goes back to what we were talking about earlier, when you have sharp edges on your preparation and then you seat the crown and it's not seated all the way. Sometimes a way around this is to look at the inner surface of the crown and just give slight adjustments to any sharp edges. You can prevent this if you make sure your preparation is perfect, but sometimes it's not and you have to look for an alternative solution. So what you can do is you can take a clued spray, spray it on the inner surface of the crown, seat the crown, take it off, look at where that occlude spray is no longer there, adjust it ever so slightly, try it back in, and see if that's allowing you to get a better seating. Now, this isn't ideal. And once again, it really starts with the preparation. If you have great preparation, great interproximal contours, and you have a great provisional, you don't need to do any of this. So make sure that step is perfect. But sometimes, you know, things aren't ideal. So adjust the intaglio if you need to. And my last tip is to take a bite wing. If you take a bite wing of the crown on the tooth before you cement it, you will know for a matter of fact that there aren't any open margins, everything is sealed properly, and it just makes you feel a little bit more at ease. So I would encourage you guys to take an x-ray or a bite wing of your crown try-in before you finalize it with whatever cement or bonding technique that you do. So those are my tips. They help me, I hope they help you, and I'll see you for the next one. Thank you.